It's a really common mistake that I hear very often, and I wanted to clarify it today in a simple way. First, I will say I am not an English teacher. I am an engineer that happens to be a native English speaker. So I'll do my best to explain, but I'm not an English teacher. Okay, so let's start. I want to talk about the difference between by and until. You may remember this from when you learned basic English. By is something that occurs before a certain point in time, before or at a particular time. And until is something that continues, and the key word here is continues until a particular time. So in Korean, we use 가지, and you kind of use them the same here, but in English, we have to distinguish between these two states. So let's look at, we'll take an engineer approach and look at a timeline here. So if we have our particular time, so our particular time is here. For example, we have a lot of deadlines in school. And so we'll say there's a particular time. And if it's something by, you're using by, something will occur before or at this time. So we'll say if it happens here, happens once, it occurs, it's done. It happened by this time. Or if it happens here or here, it happens once, usually just once, before that time. Okay, so you would, in that case, you would use by. If, however, you want to use continue is something that is continuously occurring up until this point. So you want to make sure that it's something that is continuing to occur. Okay, that's a basic explanation. Let's go to an example. So here's a very simple example. You have a sentence. I will email it to you, blank, the deadline. So the question is, do you want to use by here or until? Think about it. Okay, let's talk about if you used until. For example, if you said, okay, I think the answer is until. This, remember, is continuous. So if you use, I will email it to you until the deadline, it means that you are continually going to send me this email. So instead of, you know, you're going to send it here, you're going to send it to me this time, this time, this time. You're actually infinitely going to send me emails until the very end of the deadline. So if you use until here, you would mean you are continually sending this to me until the deadline. Please do not do that. I would get too many emails. So in this sentence, and I've heard this sentence actually a few times from students, you want to use by the deadline, because unless you really want to send it that many times, but please don't. Here, I will email it to you by the deadline. By the deadline means that you will send this email, whatever you're sending to me, only once. And it could be anytime before the deadline. As long as it's before the deadline, it's fine. So you are able to, you must send it by the deadline. If you want to change the sentence and use until, you can say, actually, I would say to you, you have until the deadline to send it to me. So you have until the deadline to send it. So that means you continuously, anytime up to this point, you can send it and I will accept it. I hope that made sense. This should be capitalized. So I hope that makes sense for the difference between by and until, and you will use it properly in the future. So good luck.